Not one for masquerade balls. You should try harder to keep up appearances. I'm sure there are people who have already noticed your absence. Shall I tell them to expect you soon, or shall we keep this sanctuary our little secret? I don't mind. I'm very good at keeping secrets. I have traveled a long way to attend this ball. It's an honor to be here, and in your presence, might I add. But I too tire from company from time to time. As a vizier, my duties vary. We'll need a reprieve from power. Some more than others. Storms come and go. The big fish eat the little fish. And people like you and I, we keep on swimming, don't we? A good place to collect our thoughts and sip something cold. There's an impressive bounty in the hall. They have perry, brandy wine, canary wine, sherry, butterbeer, and ale with spices and berries, all on very fine linens, of course. I beg your pardon, but you look a little disheveled. Your wig is in a state of disarray, and I fear that might become the next meal, garnished with gossip and served with secrets. I can help you put yourself back together, if you allow me. I have everything you need in my purse. Almost like it was fate that brought us together. Allow me to take off your wig. Your periwig, King Louis VIII of France, is responsible for this adornment. Well, he and syphilis. The STD was the worst thing to hit Europe since the Black Plague. Hair loss was one of the consequences, and baldness swept the land. And long hair was a status symbol, and the syphilis outbreak sparked a surge in wig making. Goat hair, horse hair, human hair, and then coated with powder. scented with lavender and orange. Wigs became a necessity. Only 17 and worried that his reputation would suffer. Louis hired 48 wig makers to preserve his stature. Later, the King of England, Charles II, did the same thing. It just happened to be Louis's cousin. Down to the people like a hairy rainstorm. Oh my. That is magnificent jewelry around your neck. No doubt very valuable. You're either very confident that no one would try to take it, nor you're terrified someone might try to snatch your necklace, so you keep it on you at all times. Either motivation doesn't make it any less beautiful. Allow me to touch up your makeup. We can't have any skin showing, can we? We want you as pale as the moon, like the rarest raining pearl. I won't remove the paint you already have on your face. I just apply more. I just need to mix the finest white lead and sulfur imported from Venice. Only the best ceruse for you. Just mix it. Some water and egg white. Stir it well. perfect consistency for you.
Mm-hmm. Just need a cloth. Give you a nice glaze complexion. Close your eyes, please. And of course, we have to apply it to the neck and chest as well. That's good. Now, how about your lips? Vermilion for you. Let me grind some up. Dried flowers. Cochineal. Fig milk. And beeswax.
deepest red.
There.
I'll take a brush. Hold still.
A little bit more. We want to cake this on. The reddest lips, made from the finest ingredients. There. And let's put some on your cheeks as well. Snow white skin, red lips, red cheeks. We need bright eyes. Luckily, I have just the thing. Some drops of belladonna to make your eyes sparkle. Look up for me. Other eye. Look up. Keep looking up. There. Now, to adjust your frilled collar, your colors look even. There. That is a fine rub. Some perfume. For your hair and face and skin and clothes. Mm-hmm. have some very special powder. I can promise you've never seen powder like this before. Forget your ears. Breathe it in. Breathe deep. Tricky thing. To get this close to royalty. To do research. I had to. Meticulously. Map out when and where you would be. I had to pinpoint the exact moment you would be alone so as not to disturb. Be able to touch you without you being alarmed, calling for help. I had to, little by little, use just enough magic. Your pastes and your powders. In case anyone from your time or two walk in and see something curious, appearance is so important to me. I needed to get you into a state where I could this jewel out of your necklace without resistance. And replace it with an imposter gem. Without anyone, especially you, knowing the difference. You won't remember anything when I'm gone. You'll feel fine. You'll rejoin your party. Your jewels. You'll be as enviable as ever. Except for this one. This one's mine now. Your world will be like it was. Like it is. And And I will return to my time with something that could help maintain balance or help someone else maintain balance. I have an apprentice to train.
Into my dwelling, aside from destiny. Just because I'm talking to you doesn't really mean I'm talking to you. Let me draw it out of you. Don't tell me. Relax. This is what I do. It's what I live for. You're here. For crystals. Because you like sparkly things.